In the guidance that I got from the government when I was told I was in that extremely vulnerable group and I had to stay indoors for 3 months, it includes a section on caring for your mental well-being because they realised that asking a large number of people to isolate and not go outside and avoid contact with people can cause a lot of problems. It says you may find shielding and distancing can be boring or frustrating. You may find your mood and feelings are affected, and you may feel low, worried, or have problems sleeping. I mean, the deliveries to the offices across the road at 5 o'clock this morning didn't help, but that's another thing. It says you might miss being outside with other people. And actually, it's quite good guidance, actually. And it's very similar to what I said in my first video a few days ago. It's important to keep busy. And so I thought I'd go through that guidance with you, and hopefully it'll help you if you're in this kind of situation. It says spend time doing things you enjoy. This might include reading, cooking, other indoor hobbies, or listening to your favorite radio programs, or watching TV. Ah, just put some music on.
Don't stop, never give up. Hold your head high and reach the top. Let the world see what you have got. Bring it all back to you. Hold on to what you try to be. Your individuality. When the world is on your shoulders, just smile and let it go. If people try to put you down, just walk on.
It says, at times like these, it can be easy to fall into unhealthy patterns of behaviour, which in turn can make you feel worse. There are simple things you can do to help to stay mentally and physically active during times like this. Look for ideas of exercises you can do at home on the NHS website. I'm probably a little more strict on this than you might be able to be, but I felt I had to, really. I mean, this time last year, I was just out of hospital after my stem cell transplant and I had no appetite. I couldn't keep food down. So I lost weight and then I got my appetite back and I immediately put weight on. So then I had to lose weight and then I put it back on again. So I've learned the hard way that you have to be careful what you eat and how much you eat, especially if you're not doing much exercise. But then I also wanted to do the exercise, as I said the other day, to get fit and be able to go and join in with family activities. So I brought my exercise bike and a couple of dumbbells with me.
You've been thinking of when the world seems to get too tough, bring it all back to you.
Spending time with the windows open to let in the fresh air.
See what you have got, bring it all back to you.
Bring it all back now.
Dream of
keeping at least 2 meters away from your neighbours and household members if you are sitting on your doorstep. It goes on. Constantly watching the news can make you feel more worried. If you think it's affecting you, try to limit the time you spend watching, reading, or listening to media coverage of the outbreak. It may help to only check the news at set times or limiting this to a couple of times a day. I'm going to turn this off. Try to focus on things you can control, such as your behaviour, who you speak to, and who you get information from. Every Mind Matters provides simple tips and advice to start taking better care of your mental health. It's excellent advice, worth a look, I think, even though I've made light of it and I've been a bit jokey, it is worth a look. It can't do any harm anyway, can it? And it'll probably give you some good ideas to help you cope with the weeks ahead. Because I think there will be some of you out there who are feeling a bit down about the whole thing. Definitely worth a look and trying out some of these ideas. I'm also here. Comment below if there's anything playing on your mind, and I'll try and think of something encouraging to say from my experience. Maybe there's something I can think of that will help you to feel more positive and to feel better about the situation, because I know it's difficult. But in the meantime, God bless, and I'll speak soon.